Blaine Gabbert is now well known for being one of the most reliable backup quarterbacks in the NFL. But what if I told you that at one point he was projected to be an NFL superstar? Today's video hits different for me since I am a Mizzou fan. Blaine Gabbert was one of the first college football players I fell in love with, and I'm so excited to tell his story today. We will take a look back at his rise as a player, his Mizzou career, and how the NFL has worked out for him almost 10 years later. If you love college football, or even the NFL, then this is the channel for you, as I make videos just like this, and I have so much amazing content coming in the next few weeks. So yeah, take a quick moment to subscribe, and help me reach 4K subs by the end of August. Let me know who I should do next down in the comment section, and now let's get started with what happened to Blaine Gabbert. Blaine Gabbert grew up in the St. Louis suburb of Baldwin, Missouri, but the family members before him helped establish the gene pool. His father played quarterback at Parkway High School, and his uncle played quarterback for Southern Illinois. Blaine was the oldest brother in the family, and he was an athlete from the very beginning. He eventually grew into a 6'5" frame, and he looked like he could be a future star quarterback. The Gabbert family was sometimes called the Mannings of Missouri, but they couldn't play until they were in 5th grade. Blaine took to the sport immediately and became a star. His middle school team didn't lose a game in the 3 years he was a quarterback there. His parents and coaches thought he was good, but they never imagined he would do what he was about to do. During his freshman year of high school, Blaine attended his first career football camp. He went up to the University of Nebraska, and future players such as Josh Freeman and Landry Jones joined him there. During his sophomore year, his dad brought him to California to work out with one of the best quarterback trainers in the country, Bob Johnson. After a few hours of throwing the ball around, he told his dad that Blaine had the ability to be the number one quarterback in his high school class. He had the ideal arm, size, speed, and athleticism to be a star. They left California shocked, and from there, Gabbert's stock only grew. He blew up at a Nike camp at Ohio State, and Missouri coach David Yost took serious notice. From there, Blaine began to work and practice harder and harder, and his stock began to soar. He dominated while at Parkway West High School and became a blue chip 5-star recruit. His father played for Coach Bill Callahan at Southern Illinois, and since Bill was at Nebraska now, that seemed to be where he was going to go. They were right, as Blaine initially committed to Nebraska, but once Bill was fired, he reopened his recruitment. He ended up choosing to stay home and play for Missouri. The Tigers were fresh off a season in which they were ranked number one in the final weeks of the year before they lost to Oklahoma in the Big 12 championship game, so it's not like they're going to be a downgrade for Blaine. According to 24/7 Sports, Blaine was a 4-star recruit, the number 2 pro-style quarterback, and the 35th best player in the class of 2008, but basically every other site listed him as a 5-star recruit. Going into the 2008 season, Missouri still had star senior quarterback Chase Daniel leading the way, and superstar wide receiver Jeremy Macklin catching passes. Nevertheless, Blaine was going to be the third string quarterback, but head coach Gary Pinkel decided not to redshirt him. The Tigers began the year ranked number 6 in the country, and some thought Mizzou was a legit title contender. They opened up the season with a win over number 20 Illinois, and Colin Kaepernick's Nevada team week 3. Blaine saw his first snap against Nevada, and he would only play in one more game the rest of the year. The Tigers started out 5-0 with a huge road win against Nebraska, and they were ranked number 4 in the country. They lost back-to-back games to Oklahoma State and Texas, and their title hopes went down the drain. They won 4 more games to get to a 9-2 record, but they lost to Kansas and then Oklahoma in the Big 12 championship. They went on to beat Northwestern in the Alamo Bowl to finish with a 10-4 record. Gabbert only appeared in 3 games, and he completed 5 passes for 13 yards as a freshman. Going into 2009, Gabbert was going to be the full-time starter for the Tigers, and he was going to make his first career start against Illinois in St. Louis. In front of his entire family and his playing grounds, Blaine would go on to throw for 319 yards and 3 touchdowns with another rushing touchdown in their blowout over the Illini. Blaine had already looked like he was going to be the real deal, and the sky was the limit for him. He threw for 8 touchdowns in their next 3 games, and Mizzou is now 4-0 and ranked number 24 in the country. Blaine would lose his first career start against Nebraska, and the Huskers got their revenge, you could say. They then lost to Oklahoma State and Texas, and Blaine really struggled in all 3 of those games. He did help lead them to wins in 4 of their 5 last games, and Mizzou finished the season with an 8-4 record. They would go on to get a bid in the Texas Bowl, but they would lose to Navy. As a sophomore, Blaine had his ups and downs as he threw for 3,593 yards, 24 touchdowns, and 9 interceptions. NFL scouts were drooling over him, and if he had a big junior year, he could be a top pick in the 2011 NFL draft. Going into his junior year, expectations rose for both Gabbert and Mizzou. They quickly won games against Illinois and McNeese State, before they found themselves trailing late against San Diego State. With just under a minute to go, Gabbert completed a 68-yard touchdown to wide receiver TJ Moe, and Mizzou survived. After a win over Miami of Ohio, they entered the polls and beat both Colorado and Texas A&M to climb to 6-0 and number 11 in the country. Through those first six games, Blaine struggled. He only threw 9 touchdowns in 6 games, and he just wasn't wowing anyone. He would get his chance though, as he'd soon be playing in the biggest game of his Mizzou career. Number 1 Oklahoma came to town, and so did College Game Day. At the time, Mizzou broke the record for fans at a game day event. This was going to be Blaine's time to shine. The Tigers started up the right way, as they returned the opening kickoff for a touchdown and held the Sooners off to win the game. This was arguably the biggest win in school history, and Mizzou was 7-0 and in the race for the national title. Just like the last 2 years though, the team blew their title chances with back-to-back losses to Texas Tech and Nebraska. Blaine really struggled in both of those games, but number 24 Kansas State was going to offer him a redemption chance. He threw for 2 touchdowns in a win against the Wildcats and also beat Iowa State on the road. The Tigers won 10 games and got a bid to play Iowa in the Independence Bowl. They lost that game and Mizzou went 10-3. He threw for 3,186 yards, 16 touchdowns, and 9 interceptions. He became one of the best quarterbacks in the country, despite his somewhat underwhelming stats. Many scouts believe Gabbert had all the tools to become an NFL superstar, and he was 100% locked to go in the first round. People knew he had the height, athleticism, arm, and leadership to be a good NFL quarterback, but he also had complete bust potential, as the team was going to draft him purely on potential and on a what-if basis. In a big night for Mizzou, Alden Smith would go 7th overall to the 49ers, and Blaine Gabbert would go 10th overall to the Jacksonville Jaguars. At the time, the Jags were one of the worst teams in the NFL, so this was kind of a death sentence for him. Either way, Blaine was going to be a future franchise quarterback for the Jags. At least, that's what people hoped would happen. Blaine wasn't supposed to start his first year, but the team released David Garrard, and Luke McCown struggled, so he ended up being thrown into the mix. He had a terrible offensive line, he was the youngest starting quarterback in the NFL, he played for a dysfunctional franchise, he struggled to stay healthy, and he had one of the worst receiving corps in the entire league. He battled an injury the entire season, had the second worst completion percentage, and was sacked 40 times. He got dealt a terrible hand, but he played through his injury and became the youngest quarterback in NFL history to start 14 games in a season. Going into his second year, things were supposed to get a little bit better for him. He had a new head coach, better receivers, and he actually played really well in their season opener. He won a huge game against the Indianapolis Colts, and then he began to struggle again. He was fighting through it, but then he tore his labrum, which effectively ended his 2012 campaign. 2013 was full of injuries as he started the season with a broken thumb, then lacerated his right hand, and tore his hamstring a few weeks later. Because of that, he was not himself as he threw 1 touchdown compared to 7 interceptions in the games he did play. Dysfunction and injuries had plagued his career so far, as he already played for 3 different head coaches and had 5 different injuries. Needing a change in scenery, and Jacksonville needing a new quarterback, he was traded to the 49ers in exchange for a 6th round pick. Head coach Jim Harbaugh liked Gabbert's potential, and wanted to give him a shot. He played in 1 game in 2014, and he was the backup to Kaepernick in 2015. After Colin was benched, Blaine was thrown into the mix, and he won his first start of the year against the Falcons. He had the game of his career against the Bears, where he had a huge late rushing touchdown to send the game to overtime, and then a 71-yard game-winning pass in overtime. He threw for 2,000 yards, 10 touchdowns, and he went 3-5 as a starter. He was actually the starter through 5 games in 2016, but then he went 1-4 and was benched once again. He would sign with the Cardinals the following year, and get a chance to start a few games because of injuries to Carson Palmer and Drew Stanton. Now Blaine is basically a backup, and he signed with the Tennessee Titans in 2018. He would be the backup all year, until Marcus Mariota went down with a late season injury. Blaine would start the final game of the season against the Colts, and the winner of the game would get a wild card spot. Gabbert did okay, but my Colts won that game and then went on to beat the Texans. After the season, he was cut by the Titans and picked up by the Buccaneers. He got injured, but was re-signed in 2020 to be the backup to the newly acquired Tom Brady. So what exactly went wrong for Blaine Gabbert, and why didn't he ever pan out? Well, I think it's pretty simple. He was an average quarterback with all the tools in the world to be a star, but he could just never put it all together. If you look at his time in Missouri and in the NFL, he never really had a ton of these amazing games, and everything just seemed average. He was a good player who was expected to be great, and had too high of expectations placed on his shoulders. He was drafted based on his potential and not about his ability. He was sent to one of the NFL's most dysfunctional franchises, He was young, and he struggled to stay healthy. He was such a raw player that all the stuff that happened in Jacksonville just destroyed his potential. I'm glad to see he's now made it 9 years in the NFL, though, and he will likely be a backup for a couple more. He's one of the best quarterbacks in Missouri history, and he helped me fall in love with college football. Blaine Gabbert may be a bust in some people's eyes, but he's gotten paid millions of dollars to start for multiple teams and live all around the country playing the game he loves, so he's a winner in my book. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video as much as I did, and if you did, be sure to smash that like button to show your support. If you are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe. Help me reach 4K subscribers by the end of August. Check out my video about the rise and fall of Dorial Green Beckham, and all my other What Happened To videos. Until next time though, peace.